All right, so I want you to pretend that you're drinking.
Yeah.
Bring the cup to your face. Okay. Try to bring it as close as you can to your mouth.
My tremor started, I guess was 10, 12, it may have been longer, years ago, and got progressively worse, especially over the last 2 years where the medication didn't seem to be helping at all. The tremor really prevented me from writing without my left hand trying to stabilize my right hand. And eating things, you know, such as soup, drinking, it was almost impossible to do without holding it also with my left hand. I was going to a neurologist at another hospital outside of Philadelphia, and he referred me to Dr. Boltok at Penn.
Mr. Kleinman was actually taking medication and still had problems with his activities of daily living associated with his tremor. He really wasn't ready to undergo an invasive neurosurgical procedure and be placed under general anesthetic. And when he looked at the different options that we discussed, he felt focused ultrasound would be a better option.
My father never wanted to cut through the brain. So this is a wonderful option that he was fortunate to come across.
Focused beam ultrasound is non-invasive. There are no scalpels involved. And although it is not risk-free, it does not involve any hardware, and it could potentially be done as an outpatient procedure. This procedure involves the MRI to anatomically target the location and to deliver focused beam ultrasonic waves to tightly control the lesion which is going to be made. One of the beauties of this technique involves the fact that the patient is completely awake in the MRI machine. So we can test their tremor with sonications, and we can also test to make sure that nothing untoward is happening to them.
We're looking at the anterior commissure, posterior commissure, and the thalamus, and setting up basically the targeting for this procedure. We're going to center where the target's going to be with the center of the globe. So we're put everything ready. You ready to sonicate?
Yes.
We're going to sonicate now, guys.
There's a shift in the right-left direction, so it looks like it's a little more lateral.
Yeah, let's get some real energy into the down and see what we do, right?
We'll switch to axial.
Is his BPF?
He looks good. Pressure's good. He's been great.
Mr. Kleinman? How do you feel?
We're out of here? We're good? I think we're good. I'm happy.
Focused ultrasound has been really personally exciting for me. I've been in this space now for 30 plus years. In many ways, this represents the next step.
Put your fingers like this.
Oh my. Oh my. I could do this an hour or so ago.
Ecstatic. I mean, this is just, he was so excited to get this whole procedure done.
I'd resigned myself to the fact
right.
that, you know, there was no change and it was going to be that way. But when the opportunity came along, and so I jumped on it right away and just thankful that I did.
One of the really exciting aspects of doing an awake procedure like focused ultrasound is you can really see the results immediately, and there's really an aha moment when you really feel like you've hit a therapeutic sort of sweet spot and you can really get an excellent clinical result. That's, you know, it's magic.